Oh, nice to see you again. All right, so we are still, I told you now, we are, as I step into marriage issue. And I will expect, if you want me to talk anything, if there's anything that you want me to talk about, go ahead and write it for me. Anything here you want me to talk, I'm ready to talk about it. There's no area that you want me to talk about, I'll not talk. I will answer you, if you want me to make a video, and then you want it, I will answer you. I will do it. So I'm interested in marriage because the first marriage is church. So if the enemy captured the church, you know, we have to disarm them and take it back again. All these fake pastors, they have occupied so many homes through their deceitful and the heretical messages. So I have to be putting things right through this platform. So I am into marriage now. I'll be talking more about marriage, as I said to you. All right, so on Sunday, thank you very much for always being there, and thank you for sharing the videos to other people, and also thank you for subscribing to this channel. Okay, so I'm talking today about what one pastor said about marriage, about married couple, about a wife calling the husband baby. Calling the husband my baby, that it is demonic. It is totally wrong. The first time that a man and a woman come together as husband and wife, the man, first of all, the man is a boy before he grew up and became a man. He's a boy. The woman is also a girl in his father's home before she grew up and become a lady or become a woman. So she's a girl. I am a boy before my wife is a girl. So when we come together, though we are grown up, we are matured before we get married. But I still a baby to her. My wife is also a baby to me, my baby, before we now give birth. Even as we give birth, I do tell my wife that you are my first baby. My wife always tell me, same, you are my baby boy, my first baby boy. I will tell you, you are my baby girl before God gave us, you know, our daughters and our boy. So I didn't see any reason a woman that loved the husband, even anytime, even at the age of 60, 70, 80, they are still baby. They have to see each other as baby. You have to see your husband as a baby, and the husband have to see you as a baby. Because if two of you see each other like that, you will treat each other as baby. How did you treat a baby? You take good care. You take good care of baby. You watch over the baby. You protect the baby. You don't want any bad thing. You know, you see her as a baby. Even when she make, you know, that baby make a mistake, you know, it's a baby. You will not see it as anything. Seeing your husband as a baby and your husband seeing you as a baby plays a whole lot of a big role in a marriage. It makes things very easy. It kills egoistic ego. Nothing like, I'm the man, I'm the husband. Nothing like, I'm the madam, I'm the owner of the house, I'm a big woman, you know. Nothing like that. Everything will be calm when the husband sees the wife as a baby. Something she will do, you will say, it's a baby, you know. A baby is bound to make a mistake. A baby is bound to do some certain things. So you see her like that. Likewise, when a wife sees the husband as a baby, then two of them can, oh, that's why you see simplicity. Jesus even used his little children to give illustration of those that will enter the kingdom of heaven. If you do not bring yourself down as one of this little child, you will not enter the kingdom of God. So to tell you, when you see yourself as a baby, when each of you see each other as a baby, you tolerate a lot of things. There will be tolerance. See your husband also as a brother. He is your brother. Your wife is your sister. See each other as a brother, as a sister. You can't treat your own sister you love badly, and you can't treat your own brother you love badly. So when you see each other like this, it plays a whole lot of a good role in a marriage. You can't harm each other. See your wife as your mother, and your wife should see you as a father. It also is a wonderful something because you respect your father, you honor your father, you want to give your best to your father, you take instruction from your father and your mother. So when you see your wife as your mother, you take instructions, you go to her, you honor her, you respect her, you try to give the best, you try to calm down. This is how it is. And when your wife sees you as a father, she approaches you as a father every time she comes to you, she listens to you, how you treat your father that you truly love, how you honor and respect him. It is very, very also important. And when you your husband sees, you know, your wife sees you as a king, it's also fine, and you see your wife as a queen. I want to tell you something. There is no king without a queen. Vice versa. You wash your wife like this, your wife wash you also like this, everything become perfect. Okay? Everything become beautiful, glorious, no fighting, no quarreling, no misunderstanding, even if it occurs, it is well taken care of. Love keep flowing. Two of you become a killer. No, a killer, I mean, kill your wife with love, finish her up with love. Your wife kill the man with love, finish him up with love, settle everything with love. This is all about marriage. A married couple that love is not this, is not the center of everything that they are doing, is hellfire. Once love is in the center of two of you, your wife is standing like this in the middle, is a tree of love that joined two of you together. Oh, that marriage is dangerous. The devil cannot survive because the kind of missile that will be coming out of it, oh, you understand what I mean? The kisses, the touch, the romantic moves, you understand what I'm saying? It is dangerous for the devil. It is dangerous for the devil. The names they will be calling each other, oh, dangerous for the devil. The devil doesn't want to hear that. Why the devil is entering into home these days is because the church failed to teach this kind of teaching. Your pastor end up taking advantage of all these things because you don't know it. Coming into your home, when the pastor is the center between you and your wife, your pastor, every secret thing, your wife go and say, "Pastor, my husband knows this." Everything you man, you run to your pastor. It's not everything you go and tell your pastor, even when your pastor is anointed by God. Some things you're supposed to treat with your wife, settle with your wife. If there is love there, not everything, a third party is not even allowed in marriage when two of you are doing the right thing. That's why your fake pastors end up eating your dish. Eating that beautiful dish that's meant for you. The most delicious dish in the whole world is that thing God put down there for you in the body of your wife. The most delicious. Your pastor keep on eating the most delicious food that is meant for you, to nourish you, to prosper you, to energize you, to make you to look healthier, the food that all the vitamins and the proteins, everything that the body needs is inside. Your demonic pastors sneak inside and push you away from that and sit down and enjoying this dish. If you are such a man that is always trusting your fake pastors, carrying the case of your wife, it is bound to happen to you. Such is about, it's bound to happen to you. The past, that your demonic and the fake pastor will get every information from you, sneak inside and push you away and take your position. This is the thing that is happening this end time, especially in Africa. So many pastors making advantage of weak or couples that did not know the truth or know some things. They trusted them. The funniest thing is that they trusted their pastor more than God, more than what God said. Any little thing, they run to their pastor. I know so many homes, so many marriages that these fake pastors have destroyed. Enter inside, take over the woman. Inability to know the truth, to know the right thing to do. Because any man that will teach you something like this must be a man that truly want the best for you, that truly know God and know what God said, and the person want to impart to you for you to know what is right to do. So many of you men, you talk too much. You talk any little thing your wife did, you carry it, you report to the father, to the mother, to the sister, to the pastor, to everyone. Why won't the devil snake come inside and cause you damage when you did not play your role as a man? The dish that is meant for you, let me tell you something. When you are the highest nutrients that you need, that's supposed to cause a great change in your life, is when you are having sex with your wife. Those things that comes out of her, those things that look creamy, that comes out of her, is more powerful than anything in this world. This is the reason the pastors is busy sneaking into homes, searching for women that have destiny. Devils send them to go. Once they enter and take that discharge from the woman, and they take it to their temple, they withdraw everything good in that woman. Through their evil power, they withdraw everything, and it's producing money for them, producing everything for them, and you are just suffering and suffering and suffering, not knowing that these demonic people have taken the whole thing away, have taken it to go and deposit it to their evil kingdom. And you are suffering and nothing is happening in your home or happening in your marriage. That's why I always urge that women should also know that the blessing in them is great. That's why the devil is after them. That's why the fake pastors, these fake pastors and the occultic men, they're after them. They want them to take that beautiful, that is the beautiful thing. Bible said that whoever findeth a wife, find a good thing, and find favor from God. Can't you think about it? God not say, whoever findeth a man, a husband, whoever findeth a wife. Women, you are something else, you are blessed. I pray for men to begin to appreciate you, to know what the stuff you are made of. And also, I want you to also respect your husband. Stop seeing your pastor and trusting him as God, as everything. Anything, if there's anything that comes up between you and your husband, dialogue. Sit down, solve it. Stop taking it to your pastor. Stop taking it to a third party. It's not necessary. You can solve it. Before you take it to a pastor, you have to know him. You have to trust and pray and know whether he's truly a man or man of God. Okay, you have heard what I said now. So your husband is your baby, and your wife is also your baby. Two of you are brothers and sisters. Two of you are mother and father. Two of you are also kings, king and queen. So anything you like to call your husband, go ahead and call him. Anything that, so far is a romantic, romantically inspired. It's a romantic way, something that will make him happy. Anyone, call him different names. That is beautiful and sweet. So it's my wife calls me baby. I call her also baby. I call her my queen. She called my she also called my king. I called her my sister. I called her my wife. She also called me the same thing. Sometimes I just call her name. I say, hey, Sherry. She also said, hey, Sunday. This is life. This is supposed to be. Thank you very much. Please try to. Now, wisdom, knowledge is necessary for you to survive all the strategies that the enemy has set, that they're using to get people. Thank you very much. And remember to share this message to other people if you want righteousness to reign in this world. Send to other people. Subscribe and let's move together. I love you and God bless you.